Welcome to Just Minding My Business Media LLC. Broaden the scope of exposure for your business by going beyond the interview. Learn more at www.jmmbmediallc.com or email us at jmmbradio@gmail.com. As an executive at XenoSci Ventures, Kyle sits on the leadership team for two portfolio companies, Function Growth and Wello. He runs the strategy department at Function Growth and operates as CMO for Wello. Function Growth and XenoSci Ventures specialize in using behavioral science to drive growth for their clients. Wello is on track to profitably exceed eight figures in its second year as a business. Welcome, Kyle.
Thank you so much. It's a pleasure to be here.
Yes, welcome. Okay, let me tell. Glad to have you. We've got lots of questions. First of all, let's talk a little bit about what behavioral science is so that our audience understands that.
Sure. Yeah, I would love to. So behavioral science, refers to in our world, we're operating in the D2C world between function, like you mentioned. My role is head of strategy at Function Growth and the CMO of Wello. Everyone at XenoSci Ventures is educated in behavioral science. It's one of the ways that we make decisions. So we think of behavioral science as another input, just like first party data or market research when you're making strategic decisions for a company or marketing decisions that you need to make, business decisions that you need to make. Behavioral science is all the studies that tell you how consumers behave. So it's essentially at its core, it's human behavior science. And there's tons and tons of things that we can learn from all of the studies that have been conducted to help us make more educated decisions. Sometimes, especially in our world, with Function Growth, we work with brands that are typically in the 3 to 40, $50 million range annually. And a lot of the brands that we work with are smaller. They don't have access to really expensive market studies or their own first party data because they may have just launched not too long ago. And so it's important to have some sort of foundation to be able to make smart, educated decisions for your company. And behavioral science is just another input to do that.
Okay, good.
And the D2C brands, those are direct to customer?
Exactly, yeah. Direct to consumer brands, which at its core really just means that you're selling directly to the consumers, could be through your own stores, but what it really means is that you're building that relationship and you own that relationship with your customer. So I could probably make sense. I'll take a step back just to give you the history of XenoSci. If we rewind to 2020, XenoSci was actually just one company, and we had three very differentiated departments of an ad agency. That was focused on working with bigger clients, doing year-long advertising campaigns and creative campaigns, very different from what the other part of the company, the D2C Growth Accelerator, was working with. Like I said, brands in that range that are smaller that need a much different skill set to grow. The third part is a politics agency. So we had these three different companies within XenoSci. And the Growth Accelerator had been having a lot of success working with D2C brands. And so we had the idea to start our own brand, which eventually became Wello. But that was around the time that I actually got connected with Mike Laren, who's our president of XenoSci and all these companies. And so we launched all the three different companies. Function Growth became its own company, which I'm the head of strategy of. And of course, Wello, we brought into the world at the end of 2021.
Okay, so
Yeah.
that's pretty much the story of how Wello's got launched. Or is there more?
There's more. There certainly is more. So in the D2C world, people are familiar with iOS 14. It was when Apple changed its tracking policies and made it much more difficult, in essence, for for brands to track data and target consumers, especially on Facebook and Instagram. So there's a lot of brands over the past 5 to 10 years that have been built on the back of Facebook and Instagram advertising, because it was a really relatively easy platform to develop an ad, to put it out into the market, to get it in front of who you want to get it in front of, and then draw consumers into your brand. Once iOS 14 happened, there was a lot less targeting available to brands to reach exactly who they wanted to reach on Facebook. We decided to launch our business using entirely Facebook and Instagram ads right after iOS 14, which is a debatably good decision, but it's worked out for us. And the reason it's worked out for us is we took a creative-led approach, is what we talk about a lot. But rather than relying on, outlining the specific audiences that we're going after, for instance, compression socks, we might be targeting people with specific, medical problems that compression socks help to alleviate, or specific age groups. Instead, you're relying a lot more on Facebook's algorithm, and you use creative. So instead, we develop creative that speaks to those audiences, things that we believe that they want to hear, or that will help them make a more educated decision in buying our products. And so, as we call it, creative-led approach. We use the creative. Facebook's algorithm then gets it to the people that it needs to get to based on what we have in the creative. So that's been a big factor in our strategy for launching well, and it's been really important for our success. But man, there's a lot of, it's hard to pinpoint exactly what has driven a lot of the success for Wella. But another thing I would highlight, I guess, is customer experience. We knew that customer experience would be important. We underestimated how important it would be, even though we knew it would be important. And when I refer to customer experience, that means the experience that customers are having with your brand. So that's the UI and UX of your website. It's how people use your website. It's how they navigate your website. It's the products they see. It's the imagery they see. But then it's also the one-to-one communication and customer service that you're giving to them. If they reach out to your support team to get help with an issue or to learn more about your product, all of that, we can kind of package up its customer experience, and it's just so important to build those relationships with consumers these days.
Yes, so it is.
I do have a question here. You're talking at first about very large companies, and now you're talking about you also work with smaller entities. So what would a smaller company, let's say someone who has maybe 30 employees, they haven't reached $1 million mark yet. You know, they're literally just coming out the door. Mm-hmm. How would they come to you? What would they bring to you to work with?
Yeah, it's a great question. And I think it's best clarified in the relationship that we designed for Wella. So Wella is just like any other brand that is new and just starting. And resources are, of course, limited for smaller brands. So the question is, how do you bring on the right talent and resources within your budget? And even if you are funded, it's complex and complicated to hire your own team and build your own team, or even to manage all these disparate different agencies. We designed Wello. Wello has 2 to 3 people that are full-time at Wello. And the other 30 people that work on Wello day to day are all coming from Function Growth. They're all snapped into Wello as an extension of the Wello team. My personal background, I've come from working at agencies. I've come from working at brands. I've been fractional e-commerce and marketing leadership for brands. And it's by far the most efficient way that I've come across for a new brand to get access to talent at an affordable rate. And so, the model that we use is we do a revenue share. So Wello gets a revenue share, or Function Growth gets a Wello revenue share from Wello based on success. So we have aligned incentives. If Wello is growing, function growth is getting paid more. And that's been really impactful for the growth of the brand, because you have a full team, you get access to way more talent than you would be able to do if you hired internally. Or you can a lot of the other option is, of course, to go out and hire a lot of agencies, but then these agencies all have their own processes. They don't do a good job of communicating with each other. So really the best options are to build a team internally. But of course, you hire the wrong person, that's a 6 month problem that may not reveal itself for a long time. So there's all sorts of complexities when it comes to building and staffing a team to scale up your brand. And we found a pretty good model at Function Growth, and it's worked really well for the success of Wella.
Okay, so therefore, Wello, if someone wanted to use your services, it would be a company who would that would come to you, and you're the one who has the team in place to be able to ramp up their brand recognition, their acceptance, see what the customers, how the customers feel. So they would have that data to work with. Now, do you once you get all that information for them, are you the ones who continue to, oh, sorry about that, continue
No
to
problem.
interesting. Not sure what that's about, but anyway, leave it alone. It's are you the ones who continue to work with them until they get that brand recognition? Okay.
And it's not Wello, it would be Function Growth. Wello is its own brand, its own sock company at this point.
Okay.
Function Growth is the company that snaps into brands and helps them grow. And the way that we've structured our services is that we'll typically start just to get used to working with another partner with a fixed deliverable, fixed sort of project. So it's usually somewhere between 4 and 6 months. It has specific deliverables that we know that we need to take care of for you. And they're based on three different stages of companies. You're either in a launch stage, you're in a traction stage, or you're in a scale stage, as we call it, which is you don't have a brand and you need to put something out in the world, or you maybe have a product and whatever. You might need to develop the product. You need to launch. That's step one. Step two, which a lot of founders, I think, get ahead of themselves a little bit, try to scale before they've found traction, but it's traction. It's making sure that the product and brand that you developed is actually desired in the marketplace, and that the value that you've set for it is what people want to pay, and it also has a financially solvent model, to a profitable model for you to be able to scale. And then you reach that third stage where it's all about trying to scale the brand up. And so if brands want to work with Function Growth, we'll typically take a look at where they are in that journey. We'll build some fixed deliverable projects for them. We'll execute those things. We know those things will make a strong impact on their success. Once we've gotten used to working with the founder, then we'll typically switch into a revenue share snapped in model where we're more nimble. It's not necessarily that we're just focused on this one project. You know, it is one of the reasons we structured our company the way it is you're a D2C brand. You need to try 10 different things a month to see what's going to work. And if you're working with all these different agencies with 3 6-month contracts, you're kind of stuck with one strategy for a long time. If you work with someone who's able to adapt and be nimble, you can try one thing, and if it's not working for a month and a half, then we're able to switch and say, okay, we went through the cycles there. Let's actually try something else. We know that this works, so we'll extract that and apply it in a different way, et cetera. So it gives you a more nimble model. And the reason that we don't just immediately snap in is we like to get used to working with the founders that we work with. We're really big on partnership, being long-term partners. And so we don't like to jump in head first. It's much safer to develop a relationship, get used to working with each other. A lot of times founders have a tough time giving up the freedom to work on projects and trusting us. And so it's just all about building trust in that initial phase.
Yeah. So if businesses want to work with you, how do they do so?
If businesses want to work with us, they would go to our website, functiongrowth.co, which is where they would find a form. They would fill out the form and they would get a hold of me and our partner manager, Cindy. And we would typically have a conversation about what some of the big focus areas are for the brand. And we would build out a specific proposal that I mentioned, that's a fixed deliverable project. And we would execute the project. And then, of course, if all things go well, we would snap in more fully.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Wow. This is amazing. This is a different type of structure, to say the least.
It is. Yeah. It's. We think it's a pretty innovative model. And yeah, like I said, I've had a lot of different roles in the industry, and it's been the most effective model that I've experienced so far.
Yes, yes.
For growing brands.
And we need, and it sounds like it's a flexible type structure that you have, where you are able to utilize different strategies.
It is. Yeah, very much by design. We call ourselves solution agnostic, where we like to if you work with a branding agency, for instance, and you ask them what's wrong and why things aren't working, they might point the finger at someone else, but they're not going to offer to help, or they might say it's a branding issue when it's something else. It's just not, there's not that sort of that transparency, or you really want all the different pieces of your company to be intertwined, to be working together in order to be successful. And so if we have our hands in all different parts of the company, and you ask us what's not going wrong, we're going to be honest and we're going to tell you that it's this, and we're going to say this is what we're going to try to do to fix it, or we've given up on that side of it because of X, Y, and Z, and we're going to focus on a new strategy that we think is going to make more sense. But it's yeah, I think at the end of the day, I guess it ties back into just having the transparency and trust with the partners that we work with.
Yes.
That's a unique approach. It is a unique approach.
It is.
It is entirety. Just the fact that you take on all of that branding research, really. You do all the research for them, and then you stay with them until you get things up and running, till you get the research, the positive research up and running, and look at the negative of what they're doing and say, okay, this is not working. Just let's move on. Whereas if you did it yourself, you would be spending gobs of money. And like you said, someone on different entities, and someone may just be passing the buck. You get caught in that stream. Okay, get it.
Exactly.
Okay. Very good.
Yeah.
Very fine.
Yeah, you guys are getting it. Yeah.
Yeah.
If you guys start a business, you know who to call.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly.
A D2C business.
Yes. So right now, if I wanted to get your services, I'm more interested in traction. I feel like that's where I am right now. What would that conversation sort of be between us?
Yeah. So we ask for a lot of data when more data than a typical agency would ask for up front, because we treat a lot of the times our success is tied to the success of the brands that we work with. We're doing revenue share models, sometimes even equity deals. So it's more of a due diligence round, almost like a venture capital company or private equity company would do, to make sure that we feel like your business has potential too. We don't want to work with you if we don't think your business has potential. So the first step for us is to make a connection, obviously, talk about some of the things that are going on in your business, request a lot of that data, and then do our own analysis, and we would uncover what we feel like would be the most important things to focus on based on the conversation we have with you. And you know, you would have the vision for the company that we can't necessarily extract from a website and data. But so we would talk through the vision and what are the things we want to accomplish with the company. If you want to sell your company, that's a lot different than if you want to keep your company around for a long time. You might try to invest more and accelerate your growth even faster than we would recommend if you were trying to have a long-term company that you handed down to your children. That's just an example. But anyway, so the main point is we would have a conversation with you. We would get a sense of the vision, what the goals are. We would do our own analysis on the company, see if we saw opportunity. And that's where we build that fixed deliverable project. We've already had conversations with you. We've already looked at the data. We think these are the most important things to focus on. We're going to accomplish these things. And in 6 or 4 months, we'll take a look back at what we've accomplished. We'll see how it's affected the business. And then we make a decision from there.
Okay. Got it. I mean, the more you talked at first, I was a little bit confused about the model because it seemed like it was three different companies involved. And I'm like, okay, but now that we've had this conversation and you've kind of dived in, I have a better understanding as to how things function.
Yeah.
And thank you for that, because I was not clear at first.
it's complex. It's a very complex. We're dealing with, you know, five different companies who all do very different things. But for the purposes of our conversation, we're talking about Function Growth, what we do, and Wella, which is our D2C SOC company. But
okay. So you talked about having different agencies that you work with. How does that work? If you need a company and you feel like they would be an asset to what you're doing, how does that work?
You mean as a brand who's looking for agencies, or within our own XenoSci family of agencies?
Yeah, within your family of agencies.
Yeah. So like I mentioned, XenoSci was in 2021 company with those three different departments. We are now five companies, I think. XenoSci Ventures is just the parent company. Function Growth is the growth accelerator agency that works with the D2C brands, smaller, you know, to mid-sized brands.
Mm-hmm.
Method One is the company that is the more traditional ad agency, but they work with bigger brands and they do the longer term campaigns. And then the politics company is called Z-Axis. And then, of course, we have Wello, which is our consumer product brand, which is the compression socks company.
Okay. Got you. Yeah. Okay. So again, how do you people, if they want to work with you, how do they reach out to you? Businesses.
The best way to reach out is going to be to go to functiongrowth.co. There'll be a form at the bottom of the website where you can input your information, and that form will go to me and Cindy, who's our partner development manager. You can also send me an email, khoffman@functiongrowth.co, khoffman. And those are probably the two best ways to get a hold of us. But we're like I mentioned, we're pretty selective with the partners that we work with. We want to make sure that we're set up for success. We're looking for long-term partners. We want to make sure that the business and the brands that we work with are set up for success. We won't take on too many new brands in the new year, but we will take on a few. So,
yes. Yeah. And that makes sense, because you don't necessarily need quantity, you need quality.
Exactly. Yep.
Wow. This was excellent, Kyle. Thank
yeah.
you.
Yeah.
This yeah. is a very unique structure of your companies. And I'm sure people that listen and see this interview is definitely going to have an aha moment realizing that they can work with a company that, number one, is going to be honest and transparent and really have your best interests at heart.
And that they can all get it all done in one place.
Exactly.
I think that's the biggest asset to me as a business owner is to be able to do all of these things in one
Yes.
place.
Yeah. Yeah,
So,
exactly.
and within your company, you're each holding each other accountable for getting it done. So it's, yeah, unique.
Yeah.
And I'm
Very.
sure
Yeah.
people will say, wow, I've never thought about that. Because it's never been presented to them in this fashion. They're used to doing things one at a time, one person here, just all over the place. But this is a one-stop shop.
Yes,
Yeah,
absolutely.
exactly.
Absolutely. Thank you so much, Kyle. We truly, truly appreciate this. And we are looking forward to more collaborations in the future. And keep up what you're doing. It sounds like a wonderful model, and definitely about the brand, about the the people, the business, making sure that they are successful.
Likewise, guys. Yeah, thank you for having me on today. It was a pleasure speaking with you, Beth.
Absolutely.
Likewise.